Hello and welcome to Science Monitor, a show that brings to you the most significant news from the world of science, technology, innovation, research, discoveries and much more. I'm Ashwarya Kapoor and here are this week's headlines. ISRO successfully launches intelligence satellite EMISAT and 28 other satellites of other nations including the US. Vigyan Prasar, in collaboration with All India Radio, launches a 52-episode radio series on climate change. Scientists at National Institute of Ocean Technology, Chennai, develop a robo-boat for studying deep and remote ocean areas. Vigyan Prasar organizes a three-day national workshop on science communication to inculcate a cinematic understanding of science filmmaking for scientists and research scholars. The Indian Space Research Organization or ISRO successfully launched intelligence satellite EMISAT along with the 28 satellites. The satellites were launched from ISRO's PSLV launch vehicle from Sriharikota on 1st of April 2019. The payloads were placed in three orbits and this is the first time that ISRO has provided a microgravity environment for research organizations and academic institutions to perform experiments. Science Monitor brings you a report.
In its 47th mission, India's Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle or PSLV successfully launched EMISAT from Satish Dhawan Space Center, Shah Sriharikota on 1st April 2019. EMISAT is an intelligence satellite. The satellite weighs about 436 kilograms and is based on India Space Research Organization's Indian Mini-Satellite 2 bus. The body of a satellite, also known as the bus of a satellite, holds all the scientific equipment and other necessary components of the satellite. The satellite is intended for electromagnetic spectrum measurement. Along with EMISAT, PSLV also launched 28 international customer satellites into their designated orbit. These satellites are from four countries including Lithuania, Spain, Switzerland and United States of America.
Today, PSLV C-45 has successfully injected ISRO's made EMISAT in 748-kilometer orbit as well as 28 customer satellites in 504-kilometer orbit as demanded by the customer. This time, very innovative, three experiments are attached. One is HAMSAT, another one is Automatic Identification System. The third one is built by the students of IIST, that is Advanced Retarding Potential Analyzer for Ionospheric Studies. And this type of function, the PS4, is really doing a very great helpful for Indian students to carry out experiments free of cost.
This is the first time ISRO will provide a microgravity environment for research organizations and academic institutes to perform experiments using the PS4 orbital platform. In this mission, the PS4 hosts three payloads, an automatic identification system from ISRO for maritime satellite applications capturing messages transmitted from ships. Second, an automatic packet repeating system from AMSAT or Radio Amateur Satellite Corporation, India, to assist amateur radio operators in tracking and monitoring position data. And third, Advanced Retarding Potential Analyzer for Ionospheric Studies from Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology for the Structural and Composition Studies of Ionosphere. The ionosphere is the layer of Earth's atmosphere that lies between 75 and 1,000 km above the Earth. Over the years, ISRO has taken the country to new heights and brought great laurels. In the near future, it will also launch two more satellites in August with its new rocket small satellite launch vehicle.
With the rising average global temperature, it has become important to recognize the threats caused due to changes in the climate. A key aspect to tackle climate change is to raise awareness in urban and rural areas. Vigyan Prasar and All India Radio has launched a radio series.
Climate change poses a huge risk to the livelihoods of the people across the globe. It is of supreme need to acknowledge the risk arising due to human and other activities in order to safeguard the environment. In this respect, Vigyan Prasar, an autonomous organization with the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India and All India Radio, have started a special radio show series on climate change. The 52-episode series is titled as Whispers of Wind in English and Badalti Fizai in Hindi. The shows will be broadcasted every Sunday in Hindi from 2:30 p.m. at FM Gold 101 MHz and in English at 9:30 p.m. on Rajdhani Channel. The main objective of the radio series is to create awareness about the challenges of climate change and to promote understanding about its science in a simple manner. The launch event of the series was marked by the presence of Dr. Nakul Parashar, Director Vigyan Prasar, Dr. B.K. Tyagi, Scientist and Project Coordinator Vigyan Prasar, and M. Shailaja Suman, Deputy Director General of All India Radio.
Here at this moment, climate change, as we all know, we are all experiencing it and we talk about it. And interestingly, 99% of the people talk about the changes that they are feeling, and there is one person which talks about that they're not feeling. So this is something that it's important to let the entire community 100% understand, and this understands this change of science, this climate change that's happening. And fortunately, the world over is talking about it. We have Paris, we have Poland, we have number of places where such conferences, seminars, discussions, deliberations are happening. Yet, what actually is happening on the ground and what actions have been taken and what are the benefits that will reap after we've taken these initiatives. And above all this is most important is to understand that the common man needs to understand this. The common man needs to get prepared and needs to know how to combat the issues of climate change.
Apart from Hindi and English, the show will be broadcasted nationally in 19 languages from 121 stations of All India Radio. The duration of each episode is 27 minutes. The shows will also focus on various aspects like natural and anthropogenic factors responsible for climate change, the impact of climate change, preparedness of the global community to address the challenges of climate change, and many other keynote issues. It will also bring together ideas for adaptation, mitigation, energy efficiency, and natural resource conservation.
Considering the relevancy and the national missions which the National Action Plan has worked out, we need to involve the people. First, if they will not understand the science of that climate and climate change, they will not feel, they will not find a connect with themselves. So it is just to establish that connect and their ensuring their participation for the success of those missions. That's the whole idea of this radio program.
To tackle the issue, India launched the National Action Plan on Climate Change, or NAPCC, with 8 broad national missions. Therefore, the radio series focuses and outskirts the key initiatives adopted under this mission to protect the environment. The episodes also narrate the success stories of the people involved in administrating the issues of climate change. The series will help and motivate people from different walks of the country to solve the issues of climate change and to have a better understanding towards it.
It's time for a short break, and when we return, we'll take you to the National Institute of Ocean Technology based in Chennai, where scientists have developed a GPRS-driven robo-boat. But that's after a short break. Keep watching Science Monitor. Studying water bodies is important to understand complex environmental parameters. But when it comes to the study of remote areas of the oceans or seas, it becomes a challenging task for scientists. The National Institute of Ocean Technology, based in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, has developed a robo-boat to facilitate in-depth water body studies. It is a research vessel operated with the help of sensors and controlled through a general packet radio service.
Water bodies form about two-thirds of the Earth's surface. Water bodies, like oceans and seas, play an important role in maintaining the environmental cycle. It helps to study parameters like heat, pollution, and climate change. For different types of research, scientists often need remote ocean data, but collecting resources from the water bodies near estuaries, narrow streams, and ice chunks is not an easy task. To overcome this problem and to carry out smooth research studies, scientists at the National Institute of Ocean Technology in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, have developed a robo-boat which can facilitate in-depth study of water bodies. It is designed for the purpose of research and surveillance. The robo-boat can study parameters such as conductivity, temperature, and dissolved oxygen, to name a few. It can also work to give data on coastal discharge, salinity variation, and pollution monitoring.
Here is a complexity where the oceanographers face it was, what happens to the surface close to the ocean, that is from 0 to 5 meter depth level. Herein, this robo-boat is very, very useful. The measurements could be possible. Have this with a precise way, one can continue. In addition to that, India has got an interest to study Arctic and Antarctic. In Arctic, we are having continuous measurements of various data collection. Close to the ice, it's not possible to go and have the measurement. This robo-boat will be very handy to have such measurement in Arctic.
Robo-boat is remotely operable to survey and monitor the conditions of river, coast, sea, oceans, and also to study water in polar regions. The boat is designed with sensors and can facilitate real-time data collection. For accurate observation, the boat has an underwater camera to do live video streaming. As compared to the large ocean research vehicles, robo-boat has a sleek design that can slide between small regions to collect samples. It can also go to areas which are too dangerous for a manned vessel, such as the end of a glacier. The robo-boat made by the institute is built using low-density polyethylene. It is controlled with the help of a variety of telemetry systems like satellite or GPRS for on-the-spot retrieval of information.
Robo-boat is a platform. If some other additional specialized instrument tools some scientists want to add, or some users want to add, or even for naval application, this is possible to add such tools, as it is operable either through satellite or RF. It is advantageous for us to have this platform for such wide range of applications.
The Ocean Observation Group system of the NIOT will deploy the robo-boat at the Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Arctic region for study purposes. This multifunctionality boat can also act as an aid for rescue operations in coastal areas.
To optimally utilize the potential of innovations and scientific breakthroughs, it is imperative to communicate the science behind them in a lucid and effective way. Towards this, a three-day national workshop on science communication and filmmaking was organized at CSIR, National Botanical Research Institute in Lucknow. The event focused on developing a cinematic temperament among scientists and research scholars to enable them to use films as a tool to explain their work and connect with the people. Science Monitor brings you a report.
India has a rich scientific heritage. Research and innovation in fields such as mathematics, astronomy, medicine and material science has been carried out in Indian subcontinent since ancient times. Nevertheless, India's scientific wisdom has not been adequately communicated or disseminated, thereby creating a gap between the scientific community and the common man. Scientists are the people who are at the forefront of any new research. Therefore, it becomes all the more important for them to communicate their achievements and breakthroughs in the most effective way so that appropriate solutions can be designed on the basis of their findings. To address this cause, Vigyan Prasar, an autonomous organization of the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, along with Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, or CSIR, organized a three-day national workshop on science communication and filmmaking from 28th to 30th of March at the National Botanical Research Institute in Lucknow. The objective of the workshop was to inculcate cinematic understanding of science filmmaking in scientists and researchers.
साइंस फिल्म कैसे बनाई जाए उसके बारे में एक हम आम जनमानस को स्कूल को तो बताते आए हैं पर वैज्ञानिक इसके अंदर कैसे लाभान्वित हो सकते हैं कैसे इसके अंदर प्रेरित हो सकते हैं और कैसे एक अच्छी साइंस फिल्म वो बना सकते हैं ये कमी महसूस की गई कि वो वैज्ञानिकों के अंदर अगर ये प्रतिभा का विकास किया जाए और उनसे वो फिल्में बनाई जाएँ तो वो ज़्यादा कारगर होंगी
The focus of the event was to encourage working scientists to devote time for science popularization every time after developing a certain skill. The workshop emphasized on various important elements of filmmaking like writing for science films, production process, smartphone filmmaking, editing and sound mixing, and short filmmaking. In an interactive session, Mr. Ritesh Taksande, Film and Television Institute, Pune, and Mr. Santosh Pandey, Senior Producer, ETV Bharat, discussed the important aspects of filmmaking, which includes necessary equipments like tripod, camera accessories, editing softwares, light arrangement tricks, camera angles, and zoom, etc. Different aspects of low-budget science filmmaking with DSLR camera and mobile phone were also discussed in the session.
तीन दिन की वर्कशॉप में हम साइंटिस्ट को एक स्टोरी टेलिंग कैसे आसान शब्दों में जटिल विज्ञान को आम आदमी तक पहुंचाना है क्या बेनिफिट उनको साइंस देता है जो एक्सपेरिमेंट हो रहे हैं जो रिसर्च हो रहे हैं कैसे हम फिल्मों के ज़रिए यूट्यूब चैनल बहुत सारे आजकल प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं सोशल मीडिया है आपका मीडिया है और हम इसके मार्फत इस प्लेटफॉर्म के ज़रिए कैसे हम आम आदमी और साइंस के बीच का गैप को कम कर पाएँ ये उद्देश्य है
During the three-day activity, many research scholars and scientists working in the CSIR labs across the country participated with a lot of enthusiasm.
It's time for a short break, and when we come back, we will bring you some more news on science and innovation from India and around the world. Keep watching Science Monitor. Welcome back after the break. Let's now take a quick look at some more scientific innovations and developments from India and around the world.
The National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA, has successfully completed the flight test of Mars helicopter. For this, NASA created Planet Mars Atmosphere on the Earth. The Mars helicopter weighs around 1.8 kilograms. The test flight was conducted to showcase how the helicopter will perform at Martian temperature. The helicopter is expected to land on the surface of the planet in February 2021. It is designed to fly in the thin atmosphere of the red planet. A new study published in the journal Global Planetary Changes has found that at least 16 river basins of India are low in soil moisture. For this, research data on parameters like temperature, rainfall, and soil moisture was studied for the period of 29 years from 1982 to 2010. According to the study, Ganga River Basin was found to be lowest in the soil moisture with 25% of its area prone to drought, while in South, Penna Basin was recorded lowest in soil moisture level. The study will help to analyze the impact of climate on vegetation. Researchers have revealed that about 66 million years ago, an asteroid hit the Earth, which led to the extinction of dinosaurs. The evidence of this discovery was found in North Dakota from an asteroid that hit Mexico. Researchers also discovered fossils of fish and trees with the deposits of asteroid of that time. The study was published in the journal Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences. Researchers from Australian National University have found that the disease chytridiomycosis is leading to the deaths of amphibians like frogs, toads and salamander. It has led to the extinction of about 90 species. The wildlife disease is caused by a fungus and amphibians are at high risk. The disease spreads through the skin of amphibians. The disease has spread to over 60 countries. The study was published in the journal Science. To popularize and inculcate scientific temper among the masses, various programs are being conducted throughout the year. In order to highlight the value and impact of fundamental research, Department of Atomic Energy along with Department of Science and Technology are organizing a multi-venue mega science exhibition called Vigyan Samagam. The Vigyan Samagam exhibition will be conducted across Mumbai, Bengaluru, Kolkata and New Delhi from May 2019 to March 2020. The event will showcase mega science collaborations like European Organization for Nuclear Research, Facility for Anti-Proton and Ion Research, India-based Neutrino Observatory, International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor, Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, Square Kilometer Array, 30 Kilometer Telescope. Students have the opportunity to be a part of this huge science extravaganza. For further details, log on to link provided. Shortlisted students will get the opportunity to operate the working models of the project after getting trained by project scientists. India is undertaking a large number of science communication initiatives to make science accessible to the common man through many innovative approaches.
And in the history of science this week, we remember John Hughlings Jackson, born on 4th of April 1835 in Yorkshire. He was a neurologist famous for his research work on epilepsy. Epilepsy is a neurological disorder which causes brain seizures. Jackson also studied speech defects and nervous system disorders related to brain, spinal and quad injury. He was one of the first neurologists to study brain structural damage to determine mental disorders. Jackson founded the National Society for the Employment of Epileptics in 1892. He also started journal Brain in 1878, which is published even today. He passed away on 7th of October 1911 in London. His early studies on brain damage have led to the development of better clinical neurophysiology facilities to study and diagnose diseases. Well, that is all for this episode of Science Monitor. You can send your feedback and suggestions to Science Monitor on our email ID news@vigyanprasar.gov.in. You can also write in to us at Vigyan Prasar, C24, Kutub Institutional Area, New Delhi 110016. We'll see you again next week with another episode of Science News and Innovations. Till then, goodbye and take care.